Hello, welcome to this Forex Preview at XM.com. I'm Maria Pachurthis, and joining me is investment analyst Marios Hadjikiriakos. We'll be discussing the Reserve Bank of Australia's upcoming policy meeting and the outlook for the Aussie. So Marios, the Aussie has taken a real beating lately, mainly due to its close trading relationship with China, which is likely to experience a major slowdown because of the virus outbreak. How is Australia's domestic economy doing overall, and what can we expect to hear from the RBA when it wraps up its meeting on Tuesday?
Well, the domestic economy is not really doing that well. The unemployment rate rose in January. This is very worrisome. The RBA pays a lot of attention to the labor market, and the labor market is literally moving in the opposite direction that the RBA wants. The unemployment rate is rising instead of falling. Now, at the same time, we've had some quite disappointing data for quarter four. Capital expenditure contracted, construction work done contracted, and combined, this suggests that economic growth was probably very soft in the final quarter of 2019. Now, why is that important? It shows that the economy was already losing steam before the virus outbreak in China. So the situation right now is probably much worse than it was in quarter four, because, you know, as we already mentioned, China and Australia are very close trading partners. China is the world's biggest consumer of commodities, and Australia exports raw materials. So if Chinese growth takes a very strong hit, then Australian growth will probably follow along. Now, combining all of this, I think that the RBA is probably going to strengthen its easing bias on Tuesday. They will probably say something like, we are monitoring developments very closely, and if the slowdown in China persists, or, you know, if the global outlook deteriorates further, then we might be willing to cut rates in the coming months. Now, the market at the moment is pricing in a 20% probability for an immediate rate cut at this meeting. So if they don't cut rates, that would imply that the Aussie might spike a little higher on the decision. However, if their easing bias is strong enough, if they make it clear that rates will probably be cut before very long, then any positive reaction will probably fade before long, and I think that the overall reaction in the Aussie might be negative.
Okay, so taking all this into consideration, do you think the RBA will cut rates soon? And how will this in turn affect the Aussie?
I do think they are going to cut rates soon. I don't expect a rate cut at this meeting specifically. I think that they don't want to rush into any rate cut. I think they want to examine some February data first, see how the economy fared after the virus outbreak in China, and then they'll decide whether rates should be cut, probably in April. Now, the probability for a rate cut in April right now is 55%, which I think is rather low, and I think that percentage can rise after the policy meeting if their easing signals are strong enough. Now, if that happens, that will also argue for a negative for the pain that we've seen in the Aussie to continue as more rate cuts are priced in. Now, we've already seen the Aussie collapse. It's already trading at 11-year lows. Is there light at the end of the tunnel? I'm not that certain. As long as the dominant market theme is the virus and the implication that has on the global economy, then any rebound in commodity currencies like the Aussie will probably be short-lived. So I don't expect any sustainable rallies in the Aussie over the coming weeks, at least.
Marios, thanks so much. And thanks for joining us at XM.com.